Hello, my dears. Do you like my new background? I hope so. You have this beautiful view of Rio de Janeiro, and I'm thinking about to bring different locations of Brazil for the next videos, and then you don't have to see my bedroom anymore. No? What do you think? So, anyway, in this video, I will give a brief introduction about verbs in Brazilian Portuguese. This is going to be just an introduction, okay? I will talk about some rules, some basic things that will help you to understand verb conjugation better, okay? My name is Andressa Maia, and this is Falando Nisso. Okay, so you just started to learn Portuguese, then you ask your Brazilian friend, oh, how do I say speak to speak in Portuguese? And then he answers, falar. Oh, okay, and how do I say to drink? Beber. And how do I say to go? Oh, ir. Oh, very nice. So, speak, falar, to drink, beber, to go, ir. And then you think, okay, so then I speak, eu falar, I drink, eu beber, and I go, eu ir, right? Wrong, no. And this is a very common mistake that beginners make. They don't conjugate verbs, and it sounds really weird, like eu falar, eu beber. So you have to know that when you see verbs ending with R, okay, it means that they are in the infinitive form. They are not conjugated. It's like just, you know, just the name of the action, the name of the verb. I don't know how to explain that. But it's the infinitive form. So you cannot use the infinitive form to describe your actions or, you know, somebody else's actions. Like, we speak, they speak. It's not nós falar, eles falar. Okay? You have to conjugate the verb. And then it comes the terror of everyone. Oh my god, verb conjugation in Brazilian Portuguese. There are so many different types of conjugations. Okay, but it's not that, you know, it's not so difficult because there are some patterns that you can follow and will help you to understand it better. The first thing you must know is verbs in Portuguese, they are organized in groups, in three groups, okay? So, if they end in ar, A-R, okay? It means that they belong to the first conjugation, primeira conjugação. If they end in er, E-R, they belong to the second conjugation, segunda conjugação. And if they end in ir, I-R, they belong to the third conjugation, terceira conjugação. And we have some exceptions like the verbs pôr, compor, impor, because they end in or, O-R, but they also belong to the second conjugation, okay? And why is it important to know, oh, the verb is primeira conjugação, segunda conjugação? Because all verbs, all regular verbs, this is important. I'm talking about regular verbs because, you know, just like in English, irregular verbs just don't follow patterns, okay? So I'm talking about patterns. I'm talking about regular verbs. All regular verbs that belong to the same group of conjugation, they will follow the same patterns. So, for example, if you know the pattern for the first conjugation, you will know how to conjugate all verbs ending with ah. Okay, so if you know how to conjugate falar, you will know how to conjugate dançar, cantar, andar. Okay, and the same thing happens for second and third conjugation. So I want to see the pattern for the present, okay? How to conjugate verbs in the present. So let's see this picture here. So here is the pattern to conjugate verbs in the present in Portuguese. If the verb belongs to the first conjugation, so it means that it ends in AR, when you conjugate, you have to remove the AR and add these endings for each person. So if it's I, eu, you remove the R, A, and you add an O. If it's you, or he or she, so ele, ela ou você, you remove the R and you add a. If it's we, you remove the a and you add amos. And if it's you, like plural you all, or they, eles, elas or vocês, you remove the R and you put am, okay? Am. And it's the same thing for the second conjugation, verbs ending in e, you remove the e and you add o for eu, e for ele, ela, você, emos for nós, and em for eles, elas, or vocês. And if it's a third conjugation, if the verb ends in e, you remove the e and you add o for I, e for ele, ela, você, imos for nós, and em for eles, elas, vocês. Okay? So these endings, they will work for every regular verb of these different groups. Okay? So let's see some examples and you will see what I'm talking about. So here we go. Cantar. Cantar is to sing. And it's a verb that belongs to the first conjugation. So, instead of say, eu cantar, you have to say, eu canto. So, you remove the R and you put O. She sings. Ela canta. So, you remove the R and you put A. We sing. Nós cantamos. So, you remove the R and you put amos. And they sing. Eles cantam. Then you remove the R and you put am. And that is the great thing about this pattern. The same will work for all other regular verbs of the first conjugation. So, if you have speak, falar, it will be eu falo, ele, ela, você fala, nós falamos, vocês, eles, elas, falam, okay? And if you have andar, eu ando, você anda, nós andamos, eles, elas, vocês andam. So if you know how, if you know what is the ending that you have to add, that you have to change for each person, you know how to conjugate all verbs, okay? So you can take a look. Verbs of the second and third conjugation, it's the same. So here we have the verb beber, to drink, beber. It is eu bebo, você bebe, nós bebemos, vocês, eles bebem. And partir is to leave, eu parto, você parte, nós partimos, eles partem. And the same pattern will work for different verbs, okay? Let's see the rule for the past tense, okay? I will show you just present and past for this video, and I will talk more about this in the next videos. So, in the past, I will talk about pretérito perfeito, because we actually have two ways to express the idea of past. We have pretérito perfeito and we have pretérito imperfeito. But I will make a video only to explain the difference between pretérito perfeito and pretérito imperfeito, okay? As I said in the beginning, this is just an introduction, okay? A general idea of verbs conjugation. So, let me show you the rule, the pattern for pretérito perfeito. Here we go. Verbs of the first conjugation, a, you remove a, and you add a for eu, ou for ele, ela, você, ambos for we, nós, and aram for eles, elas, vocês. If the verb is the second conjugation, ending in e, you remove the e and you add e for eu, I confuse English and Portuguese. Eu for ele, ela, você. Emos for we. And eram for eles, elas, vocês. And if it's third conjugation, ending in e, you remove the e and you add e for eu. Eu for ele, ela, você. Imos for nós. And iram for eles, elas, okay? Let's see the examples with the same verbs. So, here. Cantar. I sang. It will be eu cantei. Você, ele, ela cantou. Nós cantamos. Eles, elas, vocês cantaram. So, here you can see that the R is removed and replaced for these endings. And it will work for all other regular verbs in the past, in pretérito perfeito. Okay, so for example, falar, again, to speak. It will be eu falei, você, ela, ele falou, nós falamos, eles, elas, vocês falaram. Andar, first conjugation, to. Eu andei, você andou, nós andamos, eles andaram. So, the endings are the same for verbs belonging to the same group. Second conjugation, beber. It will be eu bebi, ele, ela bebeu, nós bebemos, eles, elas beberam. And third conjugation, partir. Eu parti. Você, ele, ela partiu, nós partimos, eles, elas, vocês partiram. Okay, so as I said, this is just a brief introduction. I think it's important that you know that there are these patterns because it will help you to understand things better. These patterns, they work for all tenses. So we have present, we have pretérito perfeito, pretérito imperfeito, we have futuro do indicativo, futuro do subjuntivo. Anyway, but all tenses have patterns, okay? And all verbs follow, all regular verbs follow these patterns, okay? So that's it for this video. I'll be making more videos to explain about verb conjugation. I know it's confusing, but anyway, I'm here to help you. If you have any doubts, leave a comment. If you have any specific doubt, oh, I would like you to talk about this tense, I cannot understand, I don't know, futuro do subjuntivo. Anyway, you can leave a comment and I'll be working on it to help you, okay? Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.